Hey guys, so welcome back. For today's video, I'm gonna be doing a full face using your current favorites.
Okay, please excuse my hair in today's video. It's a frizzy mess. It's a mess. I need to get it dyed and cut, and it's happening tomorrow, but you guys won't see that until next week. But yeah, pretend it looks cute and enjoy the video. All right, bye.
Guys on Instagram to send me over products that you are loving, and I got so many suggestions, made a huge list, did a little shopping, and here we are. So I love your recommendations. I always say it, but a lot of products that I love are because of you guys. A couple weeks ago, I did a full face of your drugstore favorites, and I still use like the majority of those products. To this day, I have a lot of new favorites, so I'm excited about this video because we have a little bit of everything. A couple high-end, a couple drugstore products, and I really tried to go through the list and pick things that I've never tried before that are brand new. So thank you guys so much for all of your messages. I'm really excited to test all these out, so I hope you guys enjoy this. Grab a snack and let's get into a full face of your current favorites. Okay, so I already have my brows done. Honestly, I didn't get a ton of brow product recommendations. I got more face recommendations than anything, so I just went ahead and did my brows off camera. The first thing I'm actually going to do is just prime my lids, and this is not like a new product that I recently got suggested. This was in my other full face of your drugstore favorites, and I still love it so much. So this is the CoverGirl Lid Lock Primer, and I'm just going to use this to prime my lids and prep them for eyeshadow. This is so good, and ever since that video when I filmed that, I think that was like a month ago at this point, I can't put this down. It's like my go-to eye primer. I love it. It's so good. I just like to use a little brush to blend it out. For eyeshadow palette today, I'm going to use the Olimar Cosmetics Spanglish palette. So you guys know I love Olimar. Their products are so good. I actually got this sent to me in PR, and I don't know why. I just must have forgot about it. I put it in my vanity, and I just haven't used it since. So we're going to test it out today. I saw this a couple times on the list, and I was like, yes! Such a great way for me to like go through my makeup also and like look for things that I haven't used in a while. So this is one of those palettes. So the first color I'm going to start off with here is I Get Cute, which is like a really light pink. And I'm going to apply that in my crease. I'm just going to fluff this in there pretty much everywhere, also outer crease, lid. This is pretty. I'm going to take this color right here called Ponte Hyper. It's like a really bright pink fuchsia color, and I'm just gonna put that on the outer crease and towards the lid as well. Let me put the brightness down a little bit. It's like super bright outside, but I want you guys to see these colors. Is that better? Yeah, okay. Wow, this is really, really pigmented. I'm gonna have a little pink and purple moment today, which growing up, that was my favorite color. My childhood room used to be purple. Like, I was obsessed with pink and purple. Wow, this is impressive. A lot of pinks tend to be really chalky. They don't really build up nicely, but this is like a gorgeous pink, and I feel like it's actually really wearable. Like, I know pink can be a little intimidating, but this is very, very pretty. I'm gonna go into this color down here called Muy Excited, which is a bright orange. That reminds me of the movie Selena, when she says, me siento muy excited. I love that. I'm just gonna put that a little bit right into the crease. Wow, this is so pretty. I mean, I've tried Olimar Cosmetic eyeshadows before, but these are really seamless colors. Like, they just layer really nicely. They blend really nicely. This is beautiful. This is giving me like summer vibes, but like, yeah. It's like when you're in fall season, me with the flannel, but you also kind of miss summer a little bit, me with the orange and pink smoky eyes. Gonna go into this color right here called Guau, which is like exactly how my family speaks. Guau, Gualmar, I love it. So I'm gonna take that color and I'm gonna spray my brush, because I do this with like all of my eyeshadows. This is intense. Okay, I'm gonna take the color right here, Eres Un Show, which is like a lighter purple, and I'm gonna put that right in the center, just to kind of help blend everything. I always like to do this. It's also gonna just give it a little extra something. I'm Okay, I decided to just take that lighter purple and just put it all the way over, and then I'll probably just add more of that pink in the crease a little bit. I never really like played my looks too much, so that's why this ends up happening. Cool, I like this. These colors blend really well. There is some fallout, but never really bothered me ever. Just do your eyes first and then your face and you'll be good to go. For mascara, I was actually really surprised. A lot of you guys mentioned the Too Faced Better Than Sex mascara. I just have a little mini version here. I don't hate this mascara, but like I just have other more affordable favorites. I never really like to spend money on expensive mascaras anymore, because again, the drugstore just has so many good ones. Definitely does show up on the lashes, but again, it's just not my favorite. I have tiny lashes, but like you can actually see the mascara, so I'll use this later on also for the lower lashes. But you know I gotta go in with falsies anyway. So Beauty Creations lashes. One of you guys told me that you love these lashes in pretty much every style, like no matter what the style, they are beautiful. So I ordered a bunch. I got like 6 more packs over here, but I'm gonna use this style today. These are their 3D faux mink lashes, which I love. And these, like, I love the fact that they're faux mink. I've never tried these before, but these are in the style Classified. I love this hot pink packaging too. I've tried Beauty Creations before and I really like the brand. They have a lot of great stuff and they're relatively super affordable. So actually, while my lash glue dries, I feel like this is definitely something that I've done before. Like I've done many looks with these kinds of colors. So I'm gonna try to make the crease a little bit less orange maybe, and I'm gonna take the shade Bump de Hyper a little bit more in there and see if I can take away from the orange and make this a little bit more pink. I know it's still like not like a, you know, revolutionary makeup look. Like I said, I've definitely done a look like this, but these are my tones. Oh, okay. See, like that, I feel like already looks a little bit less orange, doesn't it? No? Yes. There we go. Like more pinky and purpley versus like orangey. Yeah, I definitely made this look a lot more complicated than what you need it to be, but I like it now. I think now that I added less orange, more pink. These are cute because they're not overly dramatic, but they're definitely still a little wispy. Okay, now for primer. I am really excited about this. I never even knew that Peter Thomas Roth had primer. I thought they only had skincare. So this is the Skin to Die For No Filter Mattifying Primer and Complexion Perfector. So I found this at Ulta, and it's supposed to instantly blur and fill in your pores, fine lines, and imperfections with a natural looking matte finish. So I was a little skeptical about this because I don't have like very oily skin. I do have a pretty oily T-zone, but lately, I don't know, like my skin has just changed so much, but especially recently, my skin has been flaky, and that hasn't happened to me in a very long time. But I'm still gonna use this and we'll see. It's kind of like a skin tone color, which looks interesting. And I'm gonna just put this on my T-zone. Oh wow. When you rub it in, it almost looks like orange. It kind of feels like a Benefit Porefessional. Do you see how it makes my face look like orangey? It has like a tint to it. Kind of like a Benefit Porefessional, but a little bit smoother. I don't really like Benefit Porefessional, honestly. I mean, I don't use that brand anyway now anymore because they're not cruelty free, but like before, I haven't used that primer in forever. Thought it was gonna be a little bit too drying on the skin, but it actually feels really good and it's very smoothing. For foundation, I'm gonna go in with the ColourPop Pretty Fresh foundation. So this I already had. I tested this out back in the summertime and I really like it. You need a good primer with it, something that's gonna make your makeup last all day, because if not, the foundation is gonna wear off in certain areas of your face. So I have medium 80W and light 70W. I'm gonna go in with medium 80W. Okay, and I'm just gonna blend this in with my Hailey's Beauty sponge. Yeah, this is definitely like a pretty fresh, like just natural foundation. This was actually recommended a lot. A lot of you guys like this for every day. And I agree, it's a really pretty foundation. I don't know why I don't use this or I haven't used it. I feel like I was loving it for a little bit and then I kind of just forgot about it. Okay, this is good. So far, everything, like I'm loving it. Eyeshadow palette, lashes, complexion is looking good. Okay, for concealer, a lot of you guys really like this. I used to love this. I believe I talked about this like 2 years ago in like a favorites video, and I don't know why I stopped using it. I think it's just because I got other, you know, favorites, but this is the Too Faced More In This Way Multi-Use Sculpting Concealer. I actually ordered this again and this one is in shortbread. I think this is gonna be a little bit too light, but actually, definitely like a good like brightening shade. This has good coverage and everything. You know, I like this more than Tarte Shape Tape because it is less drying just like by putting it on my face. coverages. From what I can remember, the coverage is good. Yeah, this, wow, this is light. I used to literally have this concealer and I decluttered it. Because I wasn't using it. Like, I literally just had it sitting in my drawer for the longest time and never really used it. But okay, this is actually really good coverage. I'm gonna just put this right in this area to brighten because my under eyes are so light. I wanna try to balance it out. All right, jumping into cream blush, I'm gonna use the Milk Makeup Lip and Cheek Tint, and this one is in Work. This is like a natural rose color. I feel like perfect with the eye makeup. So this is one of my favorites. I love this product. It is such a pretty like everyday color and the formula is amazing. So I'm gonna just put this right on my cheeks. Love. Just gives you a really natural flush. I do really like this though. This is so pretty. Then for highlighter, a lot of you guys really like the Rare Beauty Liquid Luminizer in Enlighten. Well, I don't know about the color, but a lot of you guys told me about the Liquid Luminizer. This is the color that I have. So this, okay, it's not that I didn't like it, but it's kind of just like, for me, it was so natural that I felt like it was almost like unnecessary to like spend money on the product. But I'm gonna try it out again today because I actually haven't used this in a little bit. And I'm just gonna use my sponge just to blend it in. This is like a barely there, like super natural highlighter. I do like it though because it's not glittery, I will say that, and it doesn't emphasize texture. It just kind of gives your cheek like a just so natural dew. See, that's pretty actually. That looks better than when I tested it out. Definitely good for those like natural makeup days for sure. Okay, actually that's pretty when you build it up. Okay, wait, I'm actually like not mad about it. For powder, this was probably the most popular product. This is the Kimchi Chic Set and Bake Powder, Puff Puff Pass Powder. I got this one in translucent, which was again the most popular color. I was really surprised. This thing's huge. I did not think it was gonna be this big, but packaging is beautiful. The presentation I love, and this has really good reviews. Wow, it is so like fine, the powder. Almost feels like nothing. I like how it doesn't feel drying, like just my initial application. Feels very comfortable. Wow, that powder is really, really nice. It's so soft, like it just basically feels like nothing. Also wanted to mention this brand is vegan, cruelty-free, and paraben-free as well, so I really like that. I'm gonna add some bronzer and I'm gonna use the Ilia Drawn In Nightlife Bronzing Powder. I've actually never tried anything from this brand before. It is available at Sephora, and this color looks like everything. Like this is my perfect bronzer color. I already know I'm gonna love this, at least I think so, because like it looks so good. And I think Sephora is currently still having their VIB sale. I ordered this before the sale, so. Very, very smooth. Not muddy, builds up nicely, and this is a good color. Did I tell you the color that I got? This one is in Drawn In, I believe. Yeah. So far, really loving everything. Like this is good. This is very successful so far. So I feel a little bougie with this. This is like, feels expensive for me. So this is the Patrick Ta blush. This one is in She's Seductive, which, you know me. If you suggested this color, you know me, because this is like a bronzy kind of tone. These are my kind of tones. I'm either using a bronzer like this, like that's bronzy, or something like peachy. So this is like right up my alley. And I'm just gonna use this to set the cream blush, which kind of faded at this point with the powder, but it's fine. This is very natural. Like it gives you a wash of color, but it's super, super natural. I like the bronziness that it has to it though, because it kind of makes your cheeks look a little, just like you're naturally blushing. And I like that color. That is like a just a natural blush. Like, oh my God, he just texted me. You know, like cute. And then for highlighter, I'm gonna use the Jouer powder highlighter in Citrine. And this is just like a really light kind of gold. Feels really, really smooth. That is pretty. Ooh, That's pretty. That's smooth. For lips, I'm gonna go in with the NYX lip liner. This one is in natural. So I love the NYX lip liners. These are one of my favorites, just the traditional wooden ones. But I've actually never tried the color natural. So I was happy to see this on the list because I feel like I've tried every other like nude or natural color that they have except this one, so. Ooh. Definitely like a your lips but better kind of color. It's a good like everyday shade because it's kind of like a natural like rose color. Like again, your lips are better. I'm gonna like rub this in. Oh, I like that. Like for an everyday look, you just put this on. That is so pretty. I feel like it makes your lips really pouty too. These are really good and I think these are like $3 or $4. Like the best drugstore lip liners. And then I got so many recommendations for this brand, the Tower 28 brand. This is their Milky Lip Jelly. And this one I got in the shade Almond, which was another very popular suggestion from you guys. I've actually never even heard of this brand before. This is available at Sephora. Oh my God. This is like the perfect everyday lip color. I'm in love. Ooh, this feels good. I'm actually like, wow. Okay, I have no words. This is a perfect everyday lip color right here. This is everything. We have some winners. All right, I'm gonna finish up my lower lash line, of course. I'm gonna take the hot pink color and I'm gonna apply that on the lower lash line. Wow. The lip color is probably my favorite thing because this is like right up my alley, like just like my perfect kind of color. And I love the fact that it's so smooth and creamy. And Tower 28 is also cruelty-free and vegan as well. And then for the waterline, I'm gonna go in with the Pixie by Petra Endless Silky Eye Pen. And this one I have in the color Very Berry. I already knew I was gonna do a look like this, so I was like, okay, I have to get this color. I got this at Target. Ooh, this kind of looks like an Urban Decay 24/7 liner, which I really like these, by the way, the Urban Decay ones. The Urban Decay 24/7 liners and the ColourPop BFF Cream Gel liners, they're like my two favorite eyeliner brands, but this one kind of reminds me of that a little bit. You kind of have to go over your waterline a couple times. They're definitely not super creamy. And then I'm gonna use that Jouer highlighter, which I love, and I'm gonna put that in the inner corners of my eyes. And then I'm gonna go back into the Too Faced Better Than Sex mascara on my lower lashes. Finally, to lock my makeup into place, I'm gonna use the NYX Dewy Finish Setting Spray. So I think I used this before, like years ago. I know that I used to love the matte finish, and then I tried the Radiant Finish Spray, and it literally has so much glitter in it, so I don't think this one does, because like I said, I think I used this before. So I'm gonna use this to lock everything into place, shake it up. That smells good. Bam, we're done. Okay, so to keep this outro simple and short and sweet, I love this look and I love these products. There's only one product in here that I really did not like, and that is this Pixie Eye Pencil. I didn't get much pigment on my waterline. Maybe I got a dud or maybe it's this color. I had to go over my waterline a bunch of times. I even had to like break the tip for me to get some pigment, and my eyes unfortunately are just way too sensitive for that. That's why I typically always use the ColourPop BFF Cream Gel liners or the Urban Decay 24/7 liners, because they're very creamy and they have a bunch of colors like this as well. But yeah, for me, this was a dud. It does appear to be really pigmented when you swatch it, but actually applying it to the waterline, the pigment just is not there. But that's okay. Still love the look, and I still love everything else that I used. The eyeshadow palette, I think, is beautiful. These colors are so easy to work with, and I mean, they're very fun if you're into these kinds of shades, and if you've never tried Olimar eyeshadows, I definitely recommend them. They layer very well, they're super easy to blend, and overall, I think it's a really cute palette. So I love that. I love these lashes. Definitely check out Beauty Creations for a bunch of styles, and they're all under $10, which is amazing. I'm also obsessed with the complexion. So the Peter Thomas Roth Primer, it is so smoothing, but it's not drying on the skin, which I really much appreciate, especially with my skin these past couple weeks. Girl, it is so dry. So this is good. I like how it fills in my pores, but doesn't make my skin dry or flaky, at least not yet. And the foundation and concealer combo is everything. I think the coverage is great. The finish is nice, and it's nice and smooth, but It's really good. The Lip and Cheek Tint from Milk Makeup is great. This is a great like everyday cream blush if you're into this, or if you want to use this on your lips as well. I really like that. I really like the liquid highlighter from Vera Beauty. I think it's prettier today versus like when I first tested it out. I felt like it was a little too natural. If you build it up, you can get it to be a little bit more like, you know, there. It's not an intense highlighter. It's definitely for my everyday people out there, but it is pretty. I do like it more today versus the other times that I did use it. The Ilia bronzer is really nice too because it's warm, but it's not muddy and it's very smooth on the skin. The Jouer highlighter was also very smooth, very intense, and this is good. Jouer has really good cheek products. The setting spray was nice. I feel a little bit of the dew kind of peeking through on my forehead, which I think is pretty. It's very natural. And I had to save the best for last. This lip combo is everything, you guys. If there's one thing that you get in today's video, it is this. This is like the epitome of like your lips, but better. So shout out to you guys for putting me on to like my new favorite everyday lip combo. I love the NYX lip liners, and I can't believe I've never tried this color in natural. It is so good. And then this Tower 28 lip gloss is really nice because it's like creamy and juicy and wet on the lips, but it's not sticky. And I just love this color so much for every day. There's no shimmer or anything in it. It's just a straight up creamy wet gloss. So this right here is everything. So I love this look and I love all of these products. I'd give this video like a solid 9 out of 10, maybe like a 9.5, because the eyeliner being a dud really isn't a big deal. And I think honestly it might just be this color, but let me know if you've tried any other colors from Pixie down below. But yeah, thank you guys so much for the amazing recommendations. You guys are the best. And if you have any other product recommendations that you love, leave them down below in the comments. Thank you so much for being here. I love you guys, and I'll see you very soon in my next video. Bye.